today. Let's give him honor and praise. He's worthy. Amen?
Amen.
Let's stand to our feet and put our hands together to Jesus.
Lord, here and now, come make your presence known. Burn like a fire, awake our weary soul. Your vibrant beauty has made my heart its home. And we won't be quiet, we won't be quiet, we won't be quiet. Oh, your love is our anthem. Our song, oh, we're singing it forever, oh, we're telling everyone there's no one like our God, we're singing it forever, there's no one like our God, we're singing it forever.
Come on, church.
Contain, but overflow with praise. We shout on parade the only worthy name. We dance on the ashes of all our sin and shame.
Come on, sing it, say,
hey, we won't be quiet, we won't be quiet, we won't be quiet. Oh, your love is our anthem. Oh, your love is our song. Oh, we're singing it forever. Oh, we're telling everyone there's no one like our God. We're singing it forever. No one like our God. We're singing it forever.
God, you reign this morning over our lives.
Say you reign over the heavens. You reign over the earth. You reign over eternity. And you chose to dwell in us. You reign over the heavens. You reign over the earth. You reign over eternity. And you chose to dwell in us. You reign over the heavens. You reign over the earth. You reign over eternity. And you chose to dwell in us. Oh, your love is our anthem. Oh, your love is our song. Singing it forever. Oh, we're telling everyone there's no one like our God. We're singing it forever. No one like our God. We're singing it forever.
Thank you.
fall into and trust with all my life. Never failing, forgiven and so faithful, a holy refuge of power and life. Your loving arms so strong, Jesus, they stay as long as I want, safely here in your love and arms. Thank you, God. Always open and always reaching, they carry me through the storm and all the pain. They hold on tight when it's all insane. Your loving arms so strong, Jesus, they never let go.
Defense. Jesus Christ, my Jesus. Nothing's going to rule over you that belongs under the name of Jesus. His name's highly exalted. Jesus, we magnify your name. We bring attention to you. All the applause is for you. The accolades are about you. Lord, we just love you and lift up your name here today. Worship and magnify your mighty, wonderful, matchless name, the name of Jesus. 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 Oh, yes. Hallelujah. What a name. What a name. The name of Jesus. So powerful. Man, I just feel the power of the Holy Ghost in here right now. Come on, let's just open up and let's just wait on God. Thank you, Jesus. Yeah, I'm gonna. Just pray in the Holy Ghost. Come on, y'all just all pray. Sometimes there just aren't any words in the language to say it. Just pray in the Holy Ghost right now. I'm going to do something impossible. I'm going to blow somebody's mind. Hallelujah. I'm just going to blow somebody's mind. They've already written me off. They've already thought it was over. They wrote me off a long time ago. But I'm coming around the back end, and I'm going to do something and shock their lives. And I'm going to jerk the slack out from under them. And I'm going to bring them back to me in a powerful way. Because in me, there is resurrection power. Come on, God's got resurrection power today in this service. Resurrection. He's going to raise dreams from the dead. He's going to bring things out of the tomb. He's going to roll the stone away. Come on. He's going to bring stuff out of darkness and into his marvelous light. In the name of Jesus. It's not possible. It's not possible. It was dead a long time ago. That's what you thought. I specialize in taking things that people wrote off and bringing them back. Hallelujah. Are you open for that? Do you still believe that the name of Jesus is higher than any other name in heaven and earth and under the earth? Come on, you ought to give him a praise unlike any other praise. Anybody need something to come back from the dead? Anybody need a part of you to come back from the dead? You got to get your faith up. You got to get your joy up. You got to get your praise up. You got to get your dance up. Come on, you got to get up for this. Hallelujah. Amen. He's worthy. Amen. Yeah, no one like the Lord. Hallelujah. Man, I just feel victory in here today. If you came just saying, I need to go to church today. I mean, I love the Lord and everything. This is a last-ditch effort. I'm ready to jump off a cliff somewhere. I'm ready to end it. I can't take the pain anymore. It's too much. I'm telling you, resurrection power is here for your life today.
I want to jump in with you because this is what I was seeing in the spirit. I was seeing like a pounding, like a beating, like just like getting knocked out in the face and a hit here, a hit to the right, a hit to the left. And it's just been like you've been beat up. But this is what the Lord said. He said it's like a rocking moment for you today. And just when you thought it was over, and just when you thought you can't take it anymore, I'm telling you, there's a rise up, and you're going to knock the devil out. You're going to knock the enemy out. You're going to press back, and you're going to win. There is a victory shout. Like a Rocky, like a resurrected Jesus, this is what's happening for you today.
Thank Hallelujah. You,
thank you, Lord.
Come on, somebody ought to just tell him, hey, I don't care who's you, next to me. Move victory, over. I got to praise him right victory, now. Victory, oh, listen, you better just move because I got to give him praise. Hallelujah.
Silence the bones.
Morning. I want you to turn and just find five or six people. Tell them, don't worry about a thing. His name is above every name.
Wasn't praise and worship amazing? Amazing. How you guys doing? You guys are beautiful. I see so many beautiful faces. Wow.
Hello.
Yeah, you're welcome. Yeah. You're welcome. Yeah. So my name is Hannah.
I'm Michelle.
My name is Camille.
Camilla.
My name's Eric. And we just wanted to welcome everyone for joining us this morning.
I'm sorry.
Especially our first-time guests.
Yes. So if it's your first time here today, we would like to get you this first-time guest welcome bag, which contains an In His Presence mug, and a CD sermon from yours truly, Pastor Mel.
So, what do you usually put inside your mug?
I just put water in my mug.
Just chocolate ice cream.
Nothing special.
Ice cream? I put ice cream too. Chocolate cookie?
Yes.
With the caramel syrup?
Yes.
Do you do that?
Of course
with a sprinkle and a cherry on top?
Not everybody does that.
Every day.
Yeah,
just
every
use coffee
day
for my mug, like a normal person.
I just use it to warm up my baby's milk, so... It's a multi-purpose mug. You guys can use it for whatever you want. So if this is your first time here, all you have to do to receive this gift is raise your hand and keep it raised and wait for our greeters to make their way over to you.
First time, raise your hand, guys.
Welcome. Yeah, they're just passing around a brochure that has some information about our ministry and things you might find interesting about In His Presence Church.
Yeah, all you have to do is fill this out right here, the attachment, and after service, take it to our lobby. You'll see our first-time guest table there.
That's my line.
And there'll be someone there to exchange the...
Again.
I'm sorry.
Yeah, so after the service, you go to the lobby, and you'll find a first-time guest table, and you just exchange that card for the mug.
Awesome.
So we just want to say welcome, guys!
Welcome! And also, I just want to announce that Pastor Desiree, our awesome Pastor Desiree, will be on the Dr. Caroline Leaf Show. It's on TBN.
Woo-woo.
It's this Wednesday, March 29th. You don't want to miss it. 3:30, okay?
Don't miss it.
Yeah, all we love you, church.
All right, guys, enjoy the service.
We're going to be talking about breaking addictions at that Wednesday show. So if you know anyone that's addicted to anything, have them watch. Aren't you glad to be in the house of God? Don't you love His presence? Isn't it fun to come in and worship Him? If nobody's told you yet today, let me be the first. God loves you. You are awesome. You are made in His image and likeness, and you have all power and authority has been given unto you. You are made to rule and reign in every area of your life. You know, God so loved the world that He gave. We are the most like God when we're giving. We are born again to live, we live to give. It is a joy to give. One of the greatest joys is to see somebody come into the kingdom. This past week, I got to go to Steamboat with some preacher gals, three preachers' wives, and we went skiing, and we just had a blast. We had so much fun. And our driver that picked us up from the airport to take us to the condo, you know, of course, we asked him, you know, we shared our faith with him. We talked to him about the things of God, and he said he was an atheist. Well, you know, on the ride back, it was just me riding back. He was my driver, and we came to the conclusion that he wasn't an atheist on the ride there. He said, well, yeah. He goes, I just told you guys that, so you leave me alone about the religion stuff. And I said, you know, that's the wrong thing to say to four preachers. You know, so for 40 minutes, we each took 10 minutes. Bam! You know, one did a testimony. One preached the gospel. Mary Hudson was there. She had a prophetic word for him. You know, it was just such a powerful time. And then, of course, we prayed for him. But on the ride back, I thought, oh, this is going to be good. We talked about families. We talked about life. You know, all kinds of things, spiritual things. But when it was all said and done, and I got out of the car, I said, are you ready to receive Jesus Christ as your Lord and Savior? And he said to me, no, you know, it's a personal thing. Have anybody had that one? No, it's a personal thing. And I said, well, we can go ahead and pray right now, less than 2 minutes. And he said, with a smile, okay. So I'm saying this to encourage you on that first no, don't give up. So right then and there, he asked Jesus Christ to come into his heart. And at the end, I said to him, you know, he had this big smile. I said, did you mean that with your heart? Because we talked about this on the ride there, saying things to make people happy than saying things because it's from the heart. And he said, yes, I meant it from my heart. So he got born again, and it was such a joy. It was like the highlight of my trip. But during that trip, I also had a little bit of a low. I was, when the gals flew out, I had one day to be by myself, to be on the mountaintop, to pray, to hear from heaven, to talk to God, just to get clarity about some things. And it came up on my Facebook page, some pictures of me there last year with my mom. My mom had a stroke, and I flew there to drive her back, and she's in heaven now. So it brought back. I was there for 3 days at the Steamboat Hospital, so it was kind of bringing up some sensitive memories. And as I'm doing my river walk, which I'd planned to just pray in the Holy Ghost here from heaven, you know, the tears are coming down. And I don't know about you, if you ever get to that place where you're grieving and you're sad, and all of a sudden you remember every sad thing, and all of a sudden you're in a pity party, and it's like any negative thing, it's like the devil's bum, 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 you know, bringing up all this stuff. And I mean, I'm working myself up into a good cry. And so, you know, then I just decided to pull out my phone. I got on my Pastor Desiree Ayers page, because I know the way out of any situation is giving. And I know I have a gift of healing, so I just got on there, and I just started walking and praying for people and praying for people that they'd be healed. I mean, it took me from the funk to the mountaintop so fast, from one place to the next. And that's how we can be emotionally sometimes. That's how we can be in the way we think. But the moment you choose to give, you get out of any funk. You know, this is life lessons. When it's all about you and your woes, you're miserable. When you get all you can, you put it in the can, you sit on the can, and you're kind of like a miser, you're miserable. But when you give, when you love, when you're looking for out for the well-being of other people, you're happy. So what am I trying to say? Give. Give in every area. When we give, we get delivered from a selfish heart. When we give, we get set free of a grieving heart. When we give, we develop a generous heart. So I want to encourage you to trust God to give. He said when you give your 10%, your tithe, the rest of your 90% becomes blessed. And God can do more with that 90% than that 10% you want to hang on to and not trust God. He loves you. He wants to bless you. When he says to give, it's not to punish you. It's to set you free to be who you are in Christ. You're a giver. You're a lover. You're meant to love. You're not meant to hold unforgiveness. That will make you sick. It's quiet in this Holy Ghost. praising, dancing church. How about we just decide to get happy about giving right now? Ushers, if you go ahead and hand out the envelopes, while they're handing out the envelopes, I'm going to pray for you in a moment, but I want to say welcome online church. We're so glad you're here. And we invite you to join in on giving too. You can text to give. You can hit the computer there to give. But let me pray for everybody right now. Father, I thank you that we don't have to give, but we get to give and we live to give. And Father, I thank you for doing a work in our heart. Father, I just pray for each one of us right now, and I stand in the gap and I say, create in us a clean heart, O God. Renew a steadfast spirit within us. I thank you, Father, that our hearts are generous. Our hearts are full of love. Father, our hearts want to please you, Father God. And you say to tithes, Father, we're obedient to bring the tithes, to bring the offerings into the storehouse, your church, your house where your glory dwells, where people are saved, where people are born again, where people are set free. And Father, I pray specifically right now for any person here that needs healing. And I thank you, Father, for healing. I thank you for healing hearts. I thank you for healing minds. And I thank you, Father God, for healing bodies. I speak to pain right now and I command pain to go. And I thank you, Father God, for total freedom. Any cancer cell that's trying to arise or that's been diagnosed, I command cancer to wither up and die right now in the name of Jesus. I thank you, Father, for good news going forth that nourishes our bones. And I pray, Father, for merry hearts that do good like a medicine. And I declare by your stripes, we are healed. By the stripes of Jesus. If you agree, say amen.
Amen.
Praise God. We got all that done at once. Prayed for the sick, received the tithes and offerings.
Well, it's because you're an amazing woman.
Shared about Steamboat. You're an amazing man.
Oh, come on.
You're a superstar.
What?
You're handsome.
What?
You're good looking.
What?
I'm so blessed to have you for my husband. I think I'll give you a kiss.
My wife's a giver. All right. Amen. It's always good to give. It's the way to be closer to the Lord. The Bible makes a statement, he gave, for God so loved the world that he gave, then you recognize it's impossible to get closer with him unless you're a giver. He's the greatest giver of all time. Amen. All right. I love to give. Des and I have been giving for 35 years. It didn't come natural. It came through obedience. We just did it because he's the Lord. Amen. Amen. Say, he's the Lord. Okay, when he says to do it, you just do it. Your feelings follow later. But it's obedience is your worship. All right, I want you to turn to John 11. Big John, Matthew, Mark, Luke, John 11. Now a certain man was sick, Lazarus of Bethany, the town of Mary and her sister Martha. It was that Mary who anointed the Lord with fragrant oil and wiped his feet with her hair, whose brother Lazarus was sick. When Jesus heard that, he said, "This sickness is not unto death, but for the glory of God, that the Son of God may be glorified through it." Now Jesus loved Martha and her sister and Lazarus. So, it should say, he immediately went to their house and healed them. But it says that Jesus loved Martha and her sister and Lazarus. So, when he heard that he was sick, he stayed 2 more days in the place where he was. Come on, it's your boy. He's sick. What's going on? He's like... Oh, I just think I'll hang out here for a little bit more. And, I'll have one more of those icy things that you got going on over there. Yeah, he just said, I'm going to stay here two more days. You know, there are certain things that come into your life as a Christian. If you stick around long enough, certain things that will happen in your life that will make you question your relationship with the Lord. Not if you're saved or not, not if he loves you or not, but how close you really are. There are times when you're celebrating and, man, he's amazing. Oh, my God, he's awesome. You have no rival. You know, you got all the words down. You're singing and praising. And then something happens. And what you're really thinking is, where are you? I ain't seen you in a month of Sundays. I've been praying. And I can't find you anywhere. There are things that happen in your life that will come to test you and prepare you for the warfare that's up ahead. You know, Mary's a worshiper. A worshiper. She's a bold worshiper. She went into the midst of Jesus. He was in the room with the potentates and the Pharisees and all the big shots and all the names. She walked in like, what? She had an alabaster box and she broke it on and just started pouring this perfume oil all over the head of Jesus. And she just anointed him right there in front of all the Pharisees. And they're looking at, you ain't supposed to be in here, woman. And she didn't care. Why? She worshiped Jesus. She worshiped Jesus. She didn't care what was going on in her life. She didn't care what would happen to her. She worshiped Jesus. You know, we come in here and we praise, and I love to praise God. We praise him for the things he's done, for the things he's going to do. We praise him and give him thanksgiving for all that he's done. But we worship him for who he is. It doesn't matter. You ain't got to do nothing. I don't care if anything happened. You deserve my worship because I know who you are. Amen. Should we just give Jesus a praise right now? Come on. You don't have to wait for me to give you permission. Come on. Oh. She's a worshiper, bold, passionate, on fire. She would take her long hair and she would cry in front of him and the tears would hit his feet and the oil would come down on his feet and she would just wipe his feet and bathe his feet with her hair. Sometimes we come in here and we wrestle while we worship. You ever wrestled while you worship? Maybe you're wrestling this morning. You're wrestling with something that's going on in your life. You can't understand it. Why does it keep happening like this? This thing keeps falling. Why is this going on in my life? I love you so much, but yet the pain is too much. The hits are coming from everywhere. I mean, I can't take the pressure and the stress of it, God. You've got to do something. I'm looking for you. I'm worshiping you, but oh God, it would be great if you would just come in here and do something right now in my life. How many have ever wrestled while they worshiped? She's being tested. In the midst of what is happening, we worship him. We're worshipers. Say, I'm a worshiper. Mary worshiped like no one else. But she's got this dilemma. Lazarus is sick. He's about ready to die. He's going to die. Do you know worship prepares you for the battle? Come on, I would dare to say that some of you, the hell you've been through this last year, if you weren't a worshiper, you would have lost your mind. Come on, you would have lost your mind if you wouldn't have been a worshiper and connected to God. If you didn't have communion with God, you would have gone crazy. Am I talking to anybody? Come on, asylums are filled with people that couldn't take the pressure. There are people that have jumped off cliffs and gone crazy and blown their brains out. The kind of pressure you've been under, but you're a worshiper. You're connected to God. Come on, worship prepares you for the battle. Glory to God. Say, I'm a worshiper. fine with me. Verse 3. I ain't preached yet. Y'all been screaming and yelling. So this certain man was Lazarus, was sick. Mary and Martha were there, and they sent to Jesus, saying, Lord, behold, he whom you love is sick. And when Jesus heard that, he said, this sickness is not unto death, but for the glory of God, that the Son of God may be glorified through it. Now, we know Lazarus died, but Jesus said, no, that don't make me nervous. Why? Because I'm the resurrection and the life. I'm the resurrection and the life. That's going to make sense to you in a second. In me is resurrection power. In me is resurrection life. And Jesus loved Martha and her sister and Lazarus. So when he heard that he was sick, he stayed 2 more days in the place that he was. I think of him just waiting there. I remember him on the boat, on the ship, and the waves are coming into the ship, and the disciples are freaking out, and they go and try to find him, and they find him sleeping in the boat. What, are you crazy? We're going to die. We're going to perish. Don't you care, is what they said. Don't you care that we're going to perish? You know, he said, where's your faith? I'm right here. Where's your faith? You've already written us off. We're going to die. We're going down. You already see that we've drowned. You've gone ahead of the situation and seen that I can't do anything about it. You've already decided there's nothing I can do. And I'm on the boat the whole time, and you're scared, and you've already dreamed up some scenario that we're going to go down and we're going to drown. I remember when Jairus came to him and said, hey, look, my daughter's going to die. You got to come and heal her. He said, I'm going to heal. That's the first thing he says. Yeah, let's go. Let's go. I'll do it. All of a sudden, the woman with the issue of blood comes up and grabs a hold of his garment and distracts him and says, no, I need help right here. And Jairus is probably going, are you crazy? My daughter is going to die. Woman, leave him alone. My daughter's dying. We got to go. Come on, come on. Wait a second. I'm going to take care of this woman. And Jairus is just so panicking. My daughter's going to die. And the guy comes and said, don't bother him. She's dead. And he goes up to the room and he says, Talitha Kumi, little girl, I say to you, arise. Some of you are here today, right now, and you need resurrection in your life. Where are you, Jesus? Mary's going, where are you? Lazarus, hang in there. We called on him. He's going to come. We're friends. Where is he? I don't know, but I know he's going to come. How do you know? Because we support his ministry. He stayed at our house. We hang out with him. We're tithers. We financially support him. I know he's going to come. And yet, Lazarus died. He died. You know, I come to church, and I love it that you praise God. I love, you know, in the 35 years that I've been going to church, I've come in and people are praising God for the answers he's given them. He answered them. He touched their life, man. And they're happy. And you know, they're dancing around. If you put your stuff out there, they dance right on top of it. They don't care. They're worshipers and they're praisers. And I love it that you get your answers, but I want to find somebody that can tell me what I'm supposed to do when I don't hear from him. See, I don't mind I don't hear from him if it's not important. But I got issues in my life. I need to hear from God. What do I do when they're going to throw us out of our house? We're behind 3 months on the mortgage and we're going to lose everything. What do I do now that he left me with everything? What do I do when I was faithful to her and she found somebody else? What do I do when the doctor said, you only have about 6 weeks to live? I need you now. Man, I don't care what else you're doing. I need you to come riding in here on a white horse with Gabriel on one side and John Wayne on the other. And I need the ambulance sirens blaring. And I need you to come in here and bang that door open and start singing, Don't You Worry About a Thing. I need you to show up. I need you to throw your weight around. And then I keep praying. and I don't hear from you. I don't hear from you. Let's read. Can we read a little bit more? Okay. I'm scared to ask now. Might start something. What do you do? Come on, you prayed. You used the name of Jesus. You went through the seven steps. You entered into his gates with praise and thanksgiving. You turned around three times. You did everything. You got the tape series. You read the book. You did everything you're supposed to do and still nothing. What do you do? Anybody ever been in that situation? And I don't want to hear one more person say, just be patient. Don't come at me with that. No, I'm in a situation now. I need the Lord to answer. What do I do now? A dream died. A relationship died. A part of me died. Look at verse 14. He speaks to his disciples and he says plainly, Lazarus is dead, and I'm glad for your sakes that I was not there, that you may believe. That you may believe. Jesus, where are you? Come on. Why aren't you concerned about my situation? I want you to panic with me. I need you to get involved here with me and tell me you're a little scared about it. We only got 2 days left. I've been waiting on the money to come through. It hasn't come through. What do? I need you to panic with me. I need you to talk to me. He waited 2 days. The people you love, he's dying. Said he waited 2 days. He didn't even make it to the house. He never went to the funeral. He never made the graveside procession. It's been 4 days. Lazarus has been dead. Here comes Jesus. Sweet Mary, the one who would wipe his feet with her hair, break the oil over his head. Now she's got an attitude. If you'd have been here, my brother wouldn't have died. There's no sweet ointment. She got her hair in a bun now. She ain't wiping nobody's feet. She got attitude for days. If you would have been here, my brother wouldn't have died. I love you, so I waited. I love you, so I waited. Because I have so much ahead of you. I have so much for you. But yet you've come to the place where you've quit on me. You stopped believing that I could do it. You put it all in a tomb and put a stone over it. Now there's a stone between you and I. You have things there that you won't allow me to see or touch. You've got fears and you've got things going on in your life that you think is going to smell too bad that you don't want me to get near. Aren't you glad you got a Jesus that it doesn't stop at the stink? Come on, that he could lift you up out of the muck and the mire. He could save a wretch like you and I and put us on high. Glory to God. He's not nervous about your situation. Where'd you lay that stuff? Where did you lay that play? Where did you lay that quit? Where's that tomb that you put, that quit, that you stopped believing that I have resurrection power, that I could do something about your life, that I could turn it around, and now you're all nervous? And what happened between you and I? See, she's got to stay a worshiper because God's got better things ahead. And worship prepares you for the battle. Make no mistake about it. When God blesses you, Satan comes to steal it. Immediately, the Bible says. He comes to steal the word that's been sown in your heart. He comes to steal that part of Jesus that has now made you alive. He wants to come and put pressure and stress and financial problems and difficulties. He wants to bring the stress of life and the spirit of the world in there to kill and steal and destroy. Why? He hates God, but he can't kill God, so he comes after God's children. Are you here today? And you've got to stay in faith. Where'd you put it, Mary? What happened between you and I? When did you stop? When did I stop being your everything? You found somebody new. You found somebody new that you're depending on and believing in. Now you're believing in not all things are possible. See, I'm the all things are possible God. Now you've got somebody where it says not all things are possible. And you quit believing. You're mad. You're angry with me. Come on. When did our relationship get an obstacle in the middle between you and I, and you put a bunch of stuff in that tomb? Open it. Open it. Take me to that tomb, he said. Take me over there. Take me. No, no, no. Don't send me. You take me. We're going to walk over there together. I want you to see that you have something between us. Come here. Come here. Come on, walk me over to the tomb. Let me find the place where you stop believing that I was for you and not against you. You take me over there. Show me the fears and the flesh and the mistakes that you've made. Show me all the stuff that you've done that you think that I would leave you over, that I get nervous about. Go ahead. Show me that tomb that's got all the perversion and all of the hell that you've been doing, all the unforgiveness and all that stuff that you don't think I can see and still love you. Come on. Go ahead. What has gotten in the way of you and I? It's going to stink, Lord. It's going to smell. That's all right. Roll the stone away. That's what he's saying to every one of us today. Roll it away. What I have for you is so awesome. Thank you so much. Give her a great big hand. She can walk like nobody else. Roll the stone away. Invite him in to find those places in you. All the fears. Well, I'm afraid I won't add up. I see all my Christian friends and they're thriving, and yet I look like a failure. I don't add up. So I've just decided to be mediocre the rest of my life. I'm not going to try anymore. I'm not going to keep going anymore. I'm going to give up and just exist and just praise you and honor you. But I'm not going to be with you anymore. You're on a whole nother level. And here he's trying to pick you up out of the muck and the mire. Tell the person next to you, the stone's been rolled away. He waited 2 days. I waited because I love you. I waited because you had to address and confront those places that you put in the tomb and rolled the stone over. Because I got so much ahead of you. The blessings are going to be so amazing that if we're not tight, they will destroy you and I. They'll overtake you, take up all your time, take up all your thoughts, take up all your desires. You'll get so entailed with the blessings, you'll forget the blessor. And so he holds back because he loves you. He waited 2 days, but he died. I'll raise him. I am the resurrection and the life. How many need some things resurrected today? How many right now, you can think of two or three things that, God, I quit believing. I quit pursuing. I lost my passion. It hit me so hard. I got knocked down and didn't get up. Come on, God's saying, get your faith up today. Come on, get your praise back today. Get your joy back today. I'm the resurrection and the life. I never forgot you. I never gave up on you. You know what I like? Martha. Look at verse 20. There's something about Martha. She got some kick in her giddy up here. Verse 20. Martha, as soon as she heard that Jesus was coming, went and met him, and Mary was sitting in the house. The person that's got faith and passion always run ahead and want to be there first. All these people in the front row. I'm not looking at the back row. I'm not saying nothing about you, but No, I'm just kidding. I'm just kidding with you. Look at verse 21. Martha said to Jesus, Lord, if you had been here, my brother would not have died. If you'd have been here. If you'd have been here. That's a true statement. If you'd have been here, my brother would not have died. That's a true statement. He would have healed him. Hey, that's a good statement to say when things aren't going right in your life. You know, if I'd have been closer to Jesus, this thing probably might not have happened to me. He's the healer. He's the deliverer. He's the bondage breaker. Come on, he's your breakthrough. He's resurrection life. Okay, look. Martha said to Jesus, Lord, if you had been here, my brother would not have died. But even now, say even now. Amen. Say even now. Amen. No, you got to have a little swag. But even now. I know that whatever you ask of God, he will give you. Jesus said to her, your brother will rise again. Oh, God. Oh, here he is. I sense the Holy Spirit in here right now. I believe somebody's getting an even now miracle in this place right now. How many need an even now miracle? Oh, it looks like it's been over. It looks like it's long dead. But even now, Jesus can resurrect it. Even now. Seems like my time has passed me by. So many great churches. All these young bucks that are starting churches and got horse rim glasses and nerdy looking and all relevant looking and everything. Got cool names and on Facebook. And here I am. It could seem like my time has passed me by. But let me tell you something. I got my faith up. Amen. Come on, I've got my joy. Come on, nothing can stop what God has promised. Amen. Nothing can stop. Even now, shout it out. Even now. Say even now. He's the author and finisher of our faith. And when things have died or seem like they have died, he's the resurrection and the life. I said he's the resurrection and the life. He's the resurrection and the life, Keith. Come on, he's the resurrection and the life. Oh, it looked like, man, I need to go out and do this. I need to go out and do that. Uh-uh. God's lifting it up while you ain't even there right now. Come on, he's opening doors for you. Listen. Roll the stone away and bring what was in the darkness into his marvelous light. Come on, somebody. How many need to open the tomb? Roll the stone away. Trust God again. Put your faith in God again. Start praising God again. Start worshiping God again. Quit being casual and mediocre about your relationship with God again. He's the answer to everything. He's the answer to everything. Everything. Let's run our life and treat our life like he is the answer to everything. Why? Because he's got resurrection power. Martha said, even now, you can raise him up. I love that. Woo! I've been crying. I've been in the back room. Nobody knows it, but I've been crying because he died. I couldn't find you. You didn't say nothing. We sent for you. And I've been back there in doubt and unbelief, been trying to get all over me. But now that I'm in front of you, even now you could raise him. I know God would give you whatever you asked. I want to see the hands of the people that need an even now miracle. Now you're a believer. Even now. How many believe that even now he could do it? Now, I don't want, keep your hands up. I don't want anybody leaving. I want you to shut the doors, lock the doors. We're not going anywhere. Oh, no, uh-uh. We're going to do something. We're not going anywhere. Jesus said, it is finished. But he didn't say, I am finished. He's working in your life even now. The resurrection power of the living God. I would dare you to stand to your feet and don't worry about who's around you. Just tell him, either get on board or move over. And I would begin to praise him and thank him and believe him and let him know I'm a believer even now, even now, even now, God, even now, right now, right now, right now, right now, God. Right now, God, yes. Oh, it was dead, but oh, I know you can do it. I believe you can raise it up. Resurrection power is in the Lord. Woo! Even now. Stop the sun. Make it go back an hour. He's a time traveler. He's the creator of the universe. He already knows the end from the beginning. He already knows he's going to raise up Lazarus. Can you trust him in the process? If you're not a worshiper, you can't trust him. If you don't love his word, you're not going to trust him. If he's not your everything, you won't trust him. You're playing a game. It's Russian roulette with your life. You're going to be struggling all the days of your life trying to find him and knowing that something better should be happening. Oh, you've got to get it and worship him. You've got to make him the priority of your life. Quit playing around. I'm talking about resurrection power. The doctors gave me 4 weeks. Doctors just practicing medicine. Jesus ain't no practitioner. He's a creator. He's the one who has ruling power. He's got the name above every name in heaven and earth and under the earth. How many of your faith is higher than when you came in? You can't take me home with you. I got my own home. I got my own life to speak into. But this is how I speak to myself every day. Get up, Mel. Quit your crying. Quit your belly aching. Nothing's impossible with our God. He's still for me. He's not against me. Come on, he's the author and finisher of my faith. I'm blessed going out. I'm blessed going in. Everything I put my hands to will be blessed. Oh, I'm blessed in the city. I'm blessed in the field. I'm graced for this. I'm graced for this. Nobody else gonna speak to you like that. You gotta speak to yourself like that. You start speaking that word to yourself and joy will fill you up. Glory to God. Even now. Let's just stay here for a second. Let's just pray in the Holy Ghost. Just pray in the Holy Ghost. God's prophetically going to speak to some people right now. Your best days are just right ahead. Just right ahead. You're getting ready to turn a corner. Don't be afraid. Don't be afraid. I bind fear in the name of Jesus. No, it's not going to just be safe around the corner. It's going to be better than it ever has been. God isn't promising you the safe place. He's promising you the right place. Come on, there's going to be challenges. Many are the afflictions of the righteous, but oh, God delivers them out of all of them. Don't be afraid. Be bold. Be bold right now. Be bold in the name of Jesus. Come on, just pray in the Holy Ghost. Okay, I'm gonna say it. This is gonna rub some people the wrong way, but I'm gonna say it because it's good. It's right, it's true. you get saved and you got a vision for your life, and people preach vision to you, and we preach vision, and oh man, and this thing that you've always planned for your life, you think that's the vision of God. You don't even know the vision of God for your life until you know the Holy Spirit. He eye has not seen and ear has not heard what God has planned for those who love him. They're only made known by the Holy Spirit. Come on, I'm sensing that people's vision is starting to change. What you passionately were in love with and wanted to do all your life, it's not meaning that much to you anymore, and God's bringing a different vision to you, the one he's always planned for you, because he saw your life from the beginning to the end, and the end from the beginning. Are you listening to me? Listen. Some people are heartbroken because their vision didn't work out. It never happened. Well, listen, you've got to move beyond that and find out what God has for you. It's better than what you planned for you. And you think, oh, how could it be? Well, the one who gave his only begotten son to die on a cross for you probably loves you more than you love yourself, and you can trust him with that vision. Lift a hand to heaven right now. I thank you, Lord. I thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. I believe that the Lord is ministering to people right now. Roll the stone away. You got to roll it away. You got to love him. You got to be a worshiper. There is none like you. No one else can touch my heart like you do. I searched all life long and found there is none like you. There is none like you. No one else can touch my heart like you do. I searched and found there is none like you. If you're here today and you've rolled that stone in front of that tomb, God is saying, come on, let's bring whatever's in there out into the light. Let me wrap my arms around it and make the darkness light. You know, I like it that Jesus is at the tomb, and he tells him, "Open, roll the stone away," and then he says, "Lazarus, come forth." And a lot of preachers I've heard said, man, he's so powerful, his word is so authoritative. If he wouldn't have said Lazarus and just said come forth, every grave in Jerusalem would have gotten up out of the grave. Every grave dead person in Jerusalem would have got up. Now, I don't know if that's true, but I wouldn't doubt it. Didn't he say, let there be light? Huh? So powerful. And I want to tell you, he knows your name. He knew Lazarus' name, and he knows your name. He knows your name. He knows your name. He just wants to make sure that you don't start hiding stuff and quitting on him. And you don't start just trying to do stuff in your own strength because you don't know if he'll do it for you or be there for you or afraid of what will happen. You might be here today and he's calling you right now. Come on out. Come on. Come on. You've been in that tomb too long. You've been covered up too long. I've had him roll the stone away and I'm calling on you. Come on out. I want a relationship with you. And you have to respond. It's your time to respond to his voice. He's calling you to come out so he can release you from those things that have had a hold on you, and you can be released into victory and complete freedom in your life, full of authority and power. And it's your time to respond. So if you're here today and you say, Pastor, I've been coming to the church, or this is my first time, whatever it is, and I really enjoy it, I like it. I mean, I believe in God, but I've never asked Jesus to be the Lord of my life. I've been sitting on the throne of my own heart, and I've been afraid to give up control. I've been afraid to tell him, come on and take control of my life. I'm afraid I won't measure up, or I'm afraid I won't be able to follow him. I want you to know you can trust in him. He loves you. If you've never said, would you come in my life and be my Lord and Savior? Would you forgive me of my sins? And I'm not living for you. I know it, and I know you know it. I mean, I've tried, but I just can't do it. But if you'll come in my life and empower me to live for you, that's what I want. I don't want to keep living this life without you. I just don't know how to connect with you and walk with you. Well, the first place to do that is just a simple question. Would you be my Lord and Savior? Would you come into my life and show me who you are? Would you forgive me? I need that. Would you forgive me of all my sins and be the Lord of my life? And you know, let me tell you, when you ask that question, he'll come immediately, and he'll never leave you and never forsake you. How many people here today have prayed that prayer before and God has said yes to you? Just raise your hand right now. Look at the hands going up all over. This is a safe place. You may put your hands down. This is a safe place. We've stood just where you're standing right now and felt God tugging at our hearts and said yes to him. So with every head bowed, every eye closed, you've never made that decision, but you want to make it now. You want to settle this with God and let him know that you want him in your life. You want to be his friend. You want to know him and not just know about him. You want to be forgiven, and you want to make heaven. You don't want to live in eternity without him. So come now, Lord. If that's what you want, I'm going to count to three. I'll say it 1, 2, 3, and then you just slip your hand up in the air. And if that's you, by lifting your hand, you're saying, yes, Pastor, if you're going to pray, here's my hand. Do you see me? Would you pray for me? Would you pray for me? Just keep it up until I recognize you. The stone's been rolled away. He's called your name and said, come out of the tomb. It's your time. I'm counting right now. 1, 2, 3. I see that hand. I see that hand. I see that hand. Come on, come on. I see that hand in the back. Yes. Come on, just slip your hand straight up in the air. I see your hand. Keep your hands up. Keep your hands up. I see that hand. Anybody else, quickly, just put your hand up. That's me, Pastor. If you're going to pray, pray for me. Anybody in the back? With your hands up, I want you to look at me. With your hands up, look at me. If you got your hand up, just look at me. Just you. On my best day, I can't get you to lift your hand to a heaven you've never been to, but God's touched your life today and you believed him and you're rejoicing and saying, yes, God, I want to pray for you. Can you meet me down here right now? Come on, pray. Let me pray for you right now. You won't be the only one. Come on, if you lifted your hand, just come right now. Just come right now. Just come right now. Just meet me right here. Come on. Hey, just turn to the person next to you and say, I'll go with you. Just turn to the person next to you and say, I'll go with you. Just come right now. Come on, church. They need your encouragement. God bless you. God bless you. Bless you, sweetie. Bless you. Bless you, sir. Bless you. God bless you. Come on. We'll wait. Come on. Come on. Oh, they're still coming, church. Come on. This is why we're here. One more time. Are you positive? I'd walk up there with you. I'd be glad to stand there with you. I won't let that pastor hurt you. I'll stand right there. I'll go. Are you thinking I should go? I should be up there. I should be up there. I should be up there. Okay. We're going to pray. God's called you out of the tomb. He's called you by name. He's touched your life today. And we're going to pray right now. And the grave clothes that you've been wrapped in, they're going to fall to the ground. He's going to cut them off today. And you're going to have freedom and liberty in your life. He's going to bring healing and freedom and power and victory in your life. He's going to bring a love that's so unconditional that he loves you right where you are. He's not asking you to perform for him. He's not saying, wow, you got to do better. No, no. He's saying, I love you. This is about you and I having a relationship, not religion. So I want to pray. Would you pray out loud with me? Everybody up here, pray out loud. Would you pray? Church, would you pray with us? Say, Father, thank you for not giving up on me. Jesus, come into my life. Be my Lord. Be my Savior. Forgive me of all my sins. I need that. I know it. I haven't been living for you. I want to. I've tried. I can't do it. I'm not strong enough. But if you'll live in me, baptize me with the Holy Spirit, the power of God. If God, you'll live in me, I'll live for you. I receive it by faith today in the mighty name of Jesus. In Jesus' name, amen and amen. Yeah, come on. Okay, here's what I want to do. I want to give you a free Bible. You got to have the scriptures. You got to have it. We're going to give it to you. I want to ask you a question. I want you to do us a favor at this church. I want you to give God a year of your life. I want you to keep coming. I want you to have a commitment to him. What he started here today, he'll continue, but you have to get in agreement with him. I want you to give him a year of your life. What does that mean? Just come on Sunday. Come Wednesday nights if you can. Get water baptized. Start to make relationships in the church. Your whole life will be transformed. It's not tougher than that. It's not any more than that. God will take over and he'll lead you by his Spirit and your whole life will be transformed. I want you to give him a year of your life. Now we have a prayer room right there. They're going to take you. They're going to pray with you, give you a free Bible. You might be going through a storm right now and need help. We're going to help you. There's some wonderful counselors right behind you. I know them personally. You're going to love being with them. They're going to talk with you, show you how to be water baptized, how to connect in a great church like in his presence. So would you turn around and just say hello to them? Come on, can we give them a great big God bless you? Amen. Amen. Come on, come on. Let's tell them it's great to have you here. Just take them right on out, Sheila.
We have some announcements we're going to see.
Just stay
right
standing.
Now.
You can stay standing. It won't take long.
Pastor Mel, awesome
Hi.
Message.
Welcome to IHP Announcements. Please remember to exit through the side doors if you're not picking up your kids. Thank you so much. The school leaders will be held every Sunday at 1 p.m. right here in the sanctuary at 1 p.m. The communion service will be held on this Wednesday, March 29th. In preparation for our kids' Easter celebration, candy donations are now being accepted in the big Easter basket in the lobby. Coming in April, Passion of the Christ movie will be shown here on Good Friday at 7 p.m. and Easter is right around the corner. Thank you, IHP family. Have a blessed week.
Wow, church. Awesome job of populating heaven and plundering hell. Don't you love seeing the salvations? Wow. Just a tremendous message today by Pastor Mel. I'm telling you, something's happening here, and it's pretty exciting. I want to encourage you to bring your family, bring your friends, just raise a hand to heaven. I'm going to pray you out. Father, we thank you, Lord. We thank you for our church. We love you so much, Father. And Father, I thank you for a hedge of protection over every person here, their families, their loved ones. And I just stand in agreement with them that every family member will come to know Christ. And I thank you for Holy Ghost boldness on each one of us. Thank you for the blood of Jesus covering us. And Father, use us, Lord, this week to share our faith, to witness Jesus, to preach the gospel, to win souls, and to make disciples. In the mighty name of Jesus, everybody said, amen. See you Wednesday night.